Mark Kriegel is a very, very talented reporter. He covers sports. He covers basketball, boxing, football, you name it. But his passion is without a doubt the sweet science. So, Mark, we're here at the press room, Mayweather, my dad, a weekend. What's going on?
Rick Ross. My kid said that Joe Jonas is a big deal, but she's still in love with Justin Bieber. There's no accounting for taste.
He might be here. He might be here. He might not be here.
I think he's going to be here. She tweeted me one of his tweets. Or tweeted whatever it was.
Yeah. So. What do you think about the fight? It's here. There's nothing left said and done. No stone left unturned. The Maidana fans going for Maidana. The Mayweather fans going for Maidana. He's going to go for the power. He's going to outbox him. What do you think?
I think that what Oscar De La Hoya just told me a little while ago is largely true. That the whole world is waiting and secretly hoping for Floyd Mayweather to get old. And if you look, I went through some stuff, what other guys did when they were 37. Think about this. Pernell Whitaker retired at 37. Chavez Sr. was 33 when De La Hoya beat him the first time, at which point he was pretty much, as far as the highest caliber fighter, pretty much done. The gold medalist, Floyd's fellow gold medalist, the only guy to win a gold medal from that 96 team, David Reed retired in 2001. Roy Jones was 35 when he lost three to Tarver, Glenn Johnson, and again to Tarver. Vargas, Floyd's teammate from the 96 Olympics, retired by 30. Trinidad, 28 when he lost to Hopkins. Even Ray Robinson, when he was 36, lost to Basilio and Fulmer, if you want to go that far back. So I think that Marcos Maidana is a really intriguing opponent for Floyd. But I also can't help but wonder if, in the larger sense, what we're really talking about is Floyd fighting time, that there's something inevitable here. I asked Oscar if Maidana could have done this to Floyd when Floyd was 32, 33, 34. That, he said, absolutely not. And even think about a guy like Oscar. He was done at 35. So, I mean, Floyd, sometimes the persona drives me a little crazy, but there's no diminishing what he's done at 37. The other thing I'm interested in seeing is older guys cut. I don't know what the physiology of it is, but Ellie, check this out. Have you seen Floyd with a cut like that? That's part of getting older. And the way Floyd is getting older, you're not going to see it. It's not like some sort of football player where you go, you drop like two-tenths of a second.
An NBA player that lost
time.
His hops or has no speed anymore. I get it. But,
right.
But here's my point.
You're not going to say your fastball, the velocity went down. You're not going to see it. It's not going to be able to be measured. That's how genius is.
My answer to what you said, it makes perfect sense. It's good. However, the difference is with Floyd and every guy that you mentioned, he only fought once a year. Took 2 years off. So his wear and tear.
What about Pernell Whitaker? Did Oscar? How many fights did Oscar have? You want to talk about old guys?
But I mean, Chavez had 107 fights. But here's the thing.
How many fights did Fernando Vargas have?
But he had wars.
He had
his
wars,
style.
What about Roy Jones?
His style.
Remember, we used to talk about Roy Jones was never in a fight,
right?
Until he was in a fight, until he got his ass kicked.
And from there, he should have retired on top, best pound for pound ever. But another thing I was going to say, Mark, you have exceptions. Look at Marquez at 40 knocking out Pacquiao. Look at B-Hop at 49 still doing his thing. So there, maybe Floyd is such a special, unique specimen.
Let me turn that around.
Okay.
Let me turn that around. Did Manny get a little bit older? Did Manny get... I mean, all I'm saying is that these
things... Again, he's been in a lot of wars. So I agree. He slowed down.
These things happen imperceptibly. It's not like, you look at the metrics or whatever. His batting average has dropped. He can't hit lefties. You can't see it. You're dealing with fractions. And you're dealing with little pieces of time that you can't really measure. How do you measure how a guy slips a punch? Maybe Floyd fought because this is what there is of Floyd now. Because I don't see him putting himself in harm's way for anybody. And I don't see that fight happening with Marcos Maidana. Not taking anything away from Marcos Maidana, but I don't see that fight going down as it did the first fight 5 years ago. I'm sorry.
No, bro, no, I gotta ask you.
Must
this.
Be nervous talking.
No, 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 everybody's on it. It's something in Vegas because it's so hot outside and then freezing in the casino. I'm wearing a jacket and it's probably 200 degrees outside. But Mark, you wrote every episode of All Access. You were the writer. Too. What was it like being part of that?
You want to start fighting me about that?
No, I it was a great job. People loved it. No,
it's hard, man.
Why?
I'm used to writing
people that you interview.
Well, I'm used to writing newspaper columns. Sometimes I can dog or worship people. I don't interview at all. No, I'm used to writing newspaper columns, magazine profiles, big fat narrative books. That's a lot of words. And All Access, writing for television, it's just a couple words. It's a few words. And writing with fewer words is, in many respects, tougher than writing with a lot of words. And if you don't believe me, you can ask the people I work with wondering, why is Kriegel such a pain in the ass?
But everyone enjoyed it, and I think this was one of the best All Accesses that they've done so far. And
what did you think about Ariza, bro?
What I think about him? Listen, he needed a job and he got a
Alex
job.
Alex, do you know he got paid? Do you think he got paid?
From who?
From Mayweather. We're talking about, by the way, Alex Ariza, who has recently gone from the Garcia camp, and before that, gone from the Freddie Roach camp, my dear friend, sorry.
Alex is great at what he does. He gets results.
Well, then why did he get fired? And why does Alex get fired if he gets results?
We all get fired. I've been fired by every person that ever hired me. And I don't.
Yeah, but you come back strong.
But listen, it's boxing and drama is good. Every time you have a big story in boxing, people tune in. So it's good for the fight. It's good.
But what I'm saying, wasn't that was, I wouldn't call it a stroke of genius, but it was at least a stroke of interestingness on the part of Floyd in, I would say, welcoming and even beckoning Alex Ariza, Maidana's former strength and conditioning coach, to camp. I don't think it's going to get under Maidana's skin, but it definitely was an interesting wrinkle.
Absolutely. That's why you love boxing, because every day something new. So there, Mark Kriegel, people want to follow you. What's the Twitter, the Instagram? Well, no Instagram.
I don't have, I'm not smart enough to do Instagram. I'm not with the times. You could do that. One day you're going to show me how to do Facebook. But I am on Twitter, at Mark Kriegel.
Spell it for those, because Mark, you can spell it with a C and a K.
MarkKriegel.
There you have it, Mark Kriegel, very, very talented writer. He loves boxing. Facebook Report.com. I'm Melissa back reporting.